What causes a foreign accent? The human vocal tract isn't very big, but it can produce thousands of different sounds with its many moving parts. You can more or less open or close the lips, round them or pull them back. The tongue can move up or down, forward or back. You can make sound come through the mouth or the nose. Each different in position or combination produces a different sound. Each language only uses a small subset of all those possible sounds, but different languages use different subsets. A simple way to think of it is that when you speak, you pull out sounds from your language bag, the one your native language gave you. When you speak a foreign language, you might reach into your bag and find that it doesn't have the sound you need. Take the h sound, for example. English uses it, Russian doesn't. So what does a Russian speaker do when they reach into their bag to say hello? There is no h to pull out. There is something similar, though. H is a puff of air being pushed up through a relatively open throat. Constrict the air channel a little tiny bit with the back of the tongue, and you've got h, a sound that Russian does have that's very nearly the same. Same puff of breath, just a slightly more constricted passage through. Close enough. Pull it out of the bag and you've got hello. English word, Russian accent. So can a Russian speaker simply add h to their bag? Sort of. It's not that a Russian speaker is physically incapable of making the h sound. They can. The problem is that the bag metaphor is too simple. Speaking is not like pulling units out of a bag one by one and laying them out in a line. The act of speaking is more like throwing darts at targets. When an English speaker aims for h, they hit the target. When a Russian speaker aims for it, there's another nearby target, the h, that's easier to hit. And what's more, it has a native language force of habit magnet that will pull even a well-thrown dart towards it. Those magnets are powerful and hard to overcome. It's useful to think of speech sounds as targets. Your targets are set up by your native language. They aren't lined up with the targets in a foreign language, and if you're trying to speak that other language, your fire might be off. So is learning to pronounce another language a question of setting up your targets correctly, then? Unfortunately, no, because to make things even harder, the targets move while we speak. The English L, for example, can be different depending on where it occurs in the word. At the beginning of a word like leaf, we use a light L, made with the tip of the tongue, L. But at the end of a syllable, like in feel, it's a dark L, ol. More of the body of the tongue is raised, and it sounds less clear, darker. This is a change so subtle you probably can't even hear or feel the difference. But you can hear it when someone fails to make the change. Italian only uses the light L and not the dark L. So, I feel good becomes I feel good. They have the L target in their own language, and they can hit it, but in that English context, the target has moved. This will also mean that an American speaker might have an accent when speaking Italian. They'll use the dark L when they shouldn't, and instead of dolci, say dolci. Learning to speak with a native accent involves so much more than practicing individual sounds or words. It would be so nice if you could start by simply picking up your bag of sounds at the language store. Instead, you have to sharpen your aim on a vast field of moving targets and powerful magnets. And meanwhile, the darts are flying all around.